Hey, assalamu alaikum. This is Nasir Munad. Last time, I got some messages from different countries about the master's study in Harris School of Economics in data science. People are asking me this question too many times, so I think I can make a video for it, and people can watch it and get the same answer that I gave before all the people. So this is very important. Who actually got scholarship or got self-funding for doing their masters in Harris School of Economics. So today this video I will discuss how this course going on all throughout these 2 years. I think you get some pre-knowledge before starting the data science program in Harris School of Economics. I think you know about the Harris School of Economics. This is very renowned in university in Russia as well as the in the world. The world ranking of Harris School of Economics is now 298. When I joined in 2018, it was in 352. So how this university getting well day by day? One thing I recognize there that the teachers, the staffs, they're so much friendly and cooperative. On the other hand, they're too much organized, for maintaining the people, students, staff, everything. They're organized and they have all those things in the queue. What you need, they will give in a minute. If it is in related to the visa, if it is related to your study, they have all organized. So actually the foreign students, they're so much happy on Harris School of Economics. In the Harris School of Economics, their accommodation fees is too low for the students. It's like if you calculate in a dollar, it's like $20 or $25 for a student, and the living cost is also not so big. So all overall, this is so cheaper country than other Europe. As you know, Moscow is including the Europe, and so actually this is a very good option for doing master's, bachelor in Russia. That is one reason if people, if you are a student in computer science, mathematics, physics, so the Russia is the best choice for you, because historically Russia is very good in math, and these people are good in math, so they're always focusing on math, whatever the subject. Like if you are studying in economics, if you are studying linguistic, if you study any kind of subject, they include the math. So because of they love math, and I don't know, they're born on math maybe, right? And on the other hand, if you want to study in data science in Harris School of Economics, you have to you have to maintain some issues that I'm going to discuss these things. For data science, by default, you have to know the math. But for Harris School of Economics, you have to be focused very much on this math, because these people are like a boss on math actually. So before coming here, you have to know the intermediate level of math, linear algebra, probabilities and statistics, discrete math. So this thing, you have to know the intermediate level, then, because they're starting from the intermediate level and they go the advanced level. They have the subject very first semester, this discrete math and probability statistics. They have the number theory, a numerical analysis, they are one subject. And in the second year, you have the advanced machine learning, where they just teach you the math behind the machine learning algorithm. So this is a bit difficult if you don't know anything about math, or you know just basic, like us as Asians. I don't know why we are not very much focused on the math if we are studying in computer science or something like this. So in Europe, especially the East Europe and the Russian people, they are very much strict on math. You have to know the intermediate level of the math. So this is important. You have to follow the one thing, you need to know the math in intermediate level, then you need to know the programming. This is also, you need to know, if you want to grab the good thing from this course, not only just pass, so you have to know the math, you need to know the programming, especially they're focused on the Python. So if you know the Python, this is very good for people, good for you for doing good, good result and making some good projects, because they have too many projects according to this their syllabus. Even something that they're not including on the syllabus, but they they will like introduce during the course. So you have like maybe five projects you have to do on in some group with some groups and or alone, and in most of the time it will be in Python. You have to know the math. You have to know the like in mentally you have to be prepared for doing class every day. In the first semester, in like 3 hours, one class in 3 hours. First hour the call is like class, then it goes to the seminar, like class the teacher teach you, and the seminar you will practice with the teacher. On the other hand, they give too many assignments. This is so this makes you so like hypertense, something like this, because if you have two or three classes, everyone they give the assignment, you have to be like get back within a 2 days, 3 days. And the most problematic is like the assignment deadline should be the same, like the all teachers they give the assignment the same time, and the returning time should be same. So you have to be very calculative, you have to maintain the assignment in a proper way, because the assignment only their assessment process. The very few teachers they took like the exam in paper, but in the exam hall, but most of the teachers they give assignment, you have to send back and you'll be evaluated by it. So these three things you have to be maintained. One, you have to know the intermediate level of math in data science, you know the calculus, linear algebra, probability and statistics, and numerical theory, numerical analysis. And you have to know the programming in a better way, like intermediate level in Python. And you need to maintain the time, how to maintain the time. You have the patience for doing work on pressure. And you know the weather, another fact, like because I'm from the Asia, so I'm just my species is most of the like related to the Asian people, like Bangladesh, India, Pakistan, Sri Lanka. So we are not facing the ice or like snow. So most of the time they are in cold. So you have to maintain, you have to be prepared for yourself for like, you know, struggling with weather, struggling with new language, new culture. And another the thing, they're not very much strong in English, but they're trying to cope up in English, because after the World Cup they changed their architecture in like in architecture in linguistic linguistic sense. They include the English along with the Russian language in the metro, in super shops. So you will be like you will be survive without knowing Russian, because they're so friendly. If you don't know Russian, just go translate or try to say something. They will try their best to convince you, to make you like they try to be help you somehow. So the linguistic issue is not very big fact, but it's a fact. If you know Russian, this is very 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 good for you. You will be the like, you know, king of this Moscow or king of the Russia. You can go everywhere, you can do everything. So this is good to know language. This is good, but this is not the main fact of doing masters in data science. It's a part of the thing. So again, I just repeat some things you have to be maintained before coming Russia and Harris School of Economics and doing masters in data science. One, you have to know the math. Two, you have to know the programming language, especially in Python. Three, you have to be prepare yourself for doing too much assignment, keeping yourself on pressure, making solve, self-motivated, and facing the weather. So this thing, if you can maintain, you will be the superb. You have the very good degree on data science in masters. So you'll be the masters on the data science. So I think you get some information from me. If I am doing any wrong in my information, let me know. I will be try to be correct. If you don't understand anything this whole through the video, just comment me or just send me my message. I will give my personal website link in the description box, so you will be get my any personal number, personal everything, just so I'm very public to all to help you people. So thank you very much. In the next I will make some video about Portugal, as I'm living in Portugal doing PhD here in communication science. I'm actually working on information theory. So bye for today. Thank you, see you again. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. Thank you.